years, every day was a struggle for Carletta Johnson.
Just being a single parent with no help, just that was really, really hard.
Even harder with no car, little family support, and only a part-time job, which also meant, for her, no health care. She was relying on government-subsidized housing and food stamps to feed her three children. As for her paycheck?
It was no more than six.
$600.
Every 2 weeks.
That's every 2 weeks for you and your children.
Right.
And some days...
I was sitting in the parking lot, I was just crying. And I'm like, okay, get yourself together.
But it was all she knew, raised by a single mother herself, forced to grow up fast to help care for her five siblings. More than 1,000 miles away in Phoenix, Arizona, Jonya Coleman has a similar story.
I grew up in a single parent household with my mom, and I had seven other siblings. My mom was on government assistance for a while to be able to help feed us.
This is generational poverty.
People are often born into poverty, and it's been poverty that their mother, their grandmother, etc., has experienced.
For a family of four, it's defined as making less than $26,000 a year. More than 38 million Americans live in poverty. For Black Americans, it's one in every five, higher than Latinos, Asian Americans, and more than double the rate of white Americans. And it spills into all aspects of life. More chronic health issues, higher rates of divorce, and abuse or neglect. Climbing out can seem nearly impossible. It often requires a new job or a degree, much harder with fewer resources like transportation and childcare.